Let's just talk about relationships real quick. I'm going to give you about 7 or 8 things. I'm not going to elaborate a lot on that. I just want to give you, and you just can just deal with what's important for relationships. So number one, relationships are resources. So everybody knows this, right? Nobody is relationally bankrupt. Relationships are resources. They give you stuff, help you have stuff that you don't have money for, qualify for, things you don't know, things you don't understand. So if you're bankrupt, void of relationships, like you will be void of resources. In the kingdom of God, relationships are equity in the kingdom. So it adds value to your life. So let's just build them. Number two, relationships take risks. Like, it's okay, but everything's risky. So living in a box going, well, I don't want to build no new relationships because it's too risky. Everything is risky. So if you take that out of the equation and just deal with the fact that all relationships require risk, and you just calculate the risk, measure the risk, protect the risk, take the risk. It's a part of the process, but you need relationships to develop in order for it to be risky. The third thing is that relationships extend your reach. So relationships always make, like, they give you an advantage in an area where you have weakness. So deciding, discovering, like, where your weakness is, then you pick people, it's okay to choose relationships that don't have the same weakness as you have, that actually know what you don't know, so that it can extend your reach and make you more valuable or more available or give you an ability that you don't have. Like, if all your relationships have the same ability, the same comfort, it doesn't provide an extended reach, right? So you want your relationships to extend your reach. What is this for?
Yeah.
Relationships rescue you. They rescue you. Not so much that you need to be rescued, but if you think about it, if you ever get in trouble, you usually call on a person, right? You call on a person. Of course, you call on God, but in the earth, you call on a person. So it's like you want to have the type of relationships that don't put you in scenarios that add trouble to you, but actually relationships that have the ability to rescue you. So relationships rescue you. Like you're just talking about, I ain't have enough people, I don't know what I was gonna do, and all these people showed up to help me. And they actually rescued or came to your rescue. Obviously, relationships help you get results. They help you get results when you know how to communicate what it is that you're trying to do and that you pick people. Because relationships help you get results only if you know what you're doing. Because other than that, they get in the way, create havoc, make it more difficult, this is where most people are, where they're like, never mind, I'll do it by myself, I don't need no help. Because if you have the wrong relationship, they don't help you get results. Right. But great relationships, they always help you get results. What is this, number 5 or 6?
Six.
Relationships create reliability. So relationships require, or they create reliability. No need to having a relationship that doesn't have reliability or dependability. So, is it okay to let somebody know in the context of a relationship what your expectations are of them, you know, in the context of this relationship? Because I think if we keep being afraid to put pressure or expectations on our relationships, it's not fair, because we still have them even if we don't communicate. So it's like,
yeah,
I need to be able to rely on you for this. And telling people that up front lets them know what you're depending on them for, instead of depending on them, not telling them, and then when they disappoint you, be heartbroken, and you're holding them to something that you never communicated. And not only that, then the next relationship, you got guards up because the last person let you down, weren't reliable, and they usually weren't reliable because you just didn't say, yo, I'm expecting this, or this is my level of expectation of reliability. It's very helpful. Last one is that, and it goes along with that, is that relationships have requirements. They have requirements. And I think we just need to not be afraid to have requirements for our relationships. Any meaningful relationships are okay to have requirements. I know everybody like, oh, it's just whatever, you can take me how you leave me, or leave me how you take me, or I am, this is just who I am. But in any relationship that really matter, it's requirements. It's like, these are the ground rules, this is how I'm gonna treat you, this is how I need you to treat me, this is how I'm gonna talk to you, this is how I'm gonna need you to talk to me, this is how I'm gonna handle you. It's just requirements that go along with it. So maybe if we think about these nuances in the context of relationships, we won't be afraid to build relationships, because we don't feel like our relationships are random.
Right.
That's the bonus one, I would say. It's great when you get a beautiful surprise relationship, but relationships shouldn't be random. It shouldn't be random. It should be intentional. It's cool when you meet somebody that you didn't expect to meet, and it turned out being way more than you thought it was gonna be.
Right.
But your whole life can't be lived by stumbling into great relationships.
Mm-hmm.
At some point, it gotta just be like, this has purpose, and I'm intentionally doing it. And so I'm asking you to widen your net, increase your influence, and build some intentional relationships so that you have more people that will help you accomplish what it is you're trying to accomplish, you help them accomplish what they're trying to accomplish, and then we all can win and see their results. So that's what I need you to think about for next week. And the assignments that I'm asking you, in the context of your assignments that you're carrying, who is holding?